So my presentation is on the moon versus Mars and Margaret Hamilton. Does anyone here know who Margaret Hamilton is? Not you. You were there for my presentation.
Well, no.
Okay, well then that's good. You're going to learn about her. And apparently some people don't know the difference between Mars and the moon. Can you believe that?
I do know the difference.
Let's start. Like I said, this presentation is on Mars versus the moon and Margaret Hamilton, and by me, of course. So, for the first part of the presentation, it's going to be Mars versus the moon. Difference between Mars and the moon. So I brought something you guys can pass around and look at because, you know, You little kids need something to play with, right?
Ooh, an astronaut.
You want to hold the astronauts?
These are all 3D printed by her.
No, I like this one.
You want to hold the moon? You want to hold Mars? You want to hold this one?
Yes.
I'll just bring you little kids. It's a little NASA coin. Grab the NASA coin?
NASA coin?
Yeah, you can keep those coins. Anyways, so when you're done looking at your thing, please feel free to pass them around so that way everyone else can have a chance to look at them. Okay. See the five facts about Mars. Mars is the fourth planet from the sun. You all know that, right?
No, I didn't. I'm kidding.
These are the links to my resources. So if you want to go back and verify that I actually did my research, they're for you to go back to. Number two, Mars is there. Mars' crust is mostly made of volcanic basalt rock, and the mantle is made out of silicon, oxygen, and iron and magnesium. The core is made up of iron, nickel, and sulfur. Mars' diameter is 4,212.3 miles. Oh, by the way, the smaller planets, the smaller moon of Mars is about the size comparison. The bigger moon of Mars is so that way you can feel the texture and see everything in the big scope. Mars' distance from the sun is 141.6 million miles. Can you imagine?
Wow, that's far.
Mars looks orange because it has iron oxide and rust flowing over it.
And the moon looks red because it has
here's a fun fact that I don't have up here because I like to go off the script. Did you know that recently, well, it's more like, it's exact really recently, but it's recent enough that Mars sent InSight, it's a rover that's digging into Mars so that way they can learn what the inside is made out. That's why they now know what Mars is made of. Because InSight is in there digging and finding out what makes up Mars and why it's like that. The moon. You guys all know the moon comes up at night, right?
Yeah.
Fun fact, did you know that the moon also is responsible for our tide? So without the moon, it would be the oceans would be a lot flatter than it is now. Anyway, fun facts about the moon. The moon is Earth's natural satellite. Do you guys know what a satellite is?
Nope.
Okay, well, a satellite is a planetary moon that orbits around a planet or a bigger object. Let's see what the moon is made of. The moon's core is most likely made of a cast iron with a little bit of sulfur and nickel. Scientists believe that the mantle is made of the minerals olivine, orthopyroxene, It is also believed that it is more iron-rich than Earth's mantle. The moon's crust is mostly made up of oxygen, silicone, magnesium, iron, calcium, and aluminum. Did you know, guys, that the moon's dust particles are actually really sticky? My mom told me this. She said one of her friend, actually was one of the people that brought out everything from the inside the shuttle. And so he was taking out the cameras and stuff because that was his job. And when he picked up the camera, all the particle that was on the camera started like clinging onto him, and they put him into quarantine because they didn't know if the dust was dangerous. So that's fun. The moon's diameter is 2,158.8 miles.
Wow, that's small.
The moon's distance from the sun can be anywhere from 147 million kilometers to 152 kilometers, depending on where it is in the ocean, of course. Also, another thing that's off the script. Did you know the reason why we have a light side and a dark side of the moon is because the moon rotates about as fast as it rotates around the Earth? So basically, while it's doing this, it's not just rotating like the Earth does. It's rotating along with its orbit. So we always see the front side of the moon, what appears to us as the front side of the moon. The moon appears to be gray because of its surface is composed of magnesium, iron, calcium, aluminum, oxygen, silicone, feldspar, and phosphorus, which all have a grayish color. Now for the next part, Margaret Hamilton. Margaret and the Moon. It's how Margaret Hamilton saved the Apollo moon mission. It's actually a really, really cool story. And she's actually also the first software engineer. She's the one that made the job. Margaret Hamilton was born on August 17, 1936, in Ohio, Indiana, USA. She was the first software programmer she helped write the code for the Apollo mission, and she was the one that saved it. She was a computer scientist, systems engineer, and a business owner. She was awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom by Barack Obama on November 22, 2016. She had published 130 papers, proceedings, and reports. When she was in high school, she managed a copper mine. You all have copper mines for serious because of technology, but when you do it, it actually really is amazing. Have you guys ever visited any local caverns or anything? I mean, you should. If you haven't, you should. They are amazing to see. When the model was preparing to land, a miscue caused the guidance computer to overload. It was her code that saved the mission. So basically, thinking of that. The astronaut, so when she was testing the systems, her little daughter wanted to play in it, so she let her go in because, you know, why not? And it was the simulator, not the rocket thing, so all right. She accidentally flipped the pre-launch switch while it was in launch mode, and that's when she realized that they needed a backup for just in case that happened. And guess what? The astronaut pushed the same switch as the little girl. And so they were over here. When she was reading a young family during